You know, as part of my efforts in preserving the legacy of my Sifu master Kuo Lien Ying, I sometimes present videos of a historical nature. These might include footage from the old days, film footage, or might include photos and sometimes even stories. One of the major events was in the 1970s of a TV evening show called Evening Magazine, and it was hosted by Jan Yanahiro and Steve Fox. In the interview, you see Jan Yanahiro interviewing Sifu, and they had to hire a special translator from the Chinese Cultural Center to translate. KPX Evening Magazine was a show dedicated to show local events around the San Francisco Bay Area. Many of my videos from the past include some of the outtakes from this TV show, but so far I haven't really shown the full interview, just clips of it. So, in my efforts to preserve the legacy, I'm presenting what I have of the actual interview. It was broken up into bits and pieces in the recording, so I had to kind of piece it together. But this is everything that I have of the interview with Sifu, so it's a pretty important segment. And this is from Bing Gong's private collection. I wasn't there that morning, so I missed out being in the filming, but I did do some research and I found out that the evening magazine show originally was called Evening. But and later they changed to Evening Magazine. Didn't start to 1976, so there was an error in my past video where I stated the clips came from 1975. You know, this was a long time ago, and so memories do fade. So I'm just trying to piece everything together to present this historical footage and give people a glimpse of what it was like in those old days to study in Portsmouth Square. It was really a small world back in those days because we didn't have the internet or any kind of really outside information to kind of give us a perspective of where we were in the Kung Fu world. And so all we had basically was Sifu and our little culture there studying with Sifu, and that was our whole world. And we really didn't think about it in the context of the whole world. So a lot of it was just kind of taken for granted, actually. We didn't really realize what a golden moment that was. And so it's only now that we're trying to piece it all back together. And luckily, we do have some of this old footage. And as well, I was a art student majoring at the Art Institute in filmmaking, photography, and painting. And so I did carry around a camera a lot, and sometimes a old 8mm film camera. So that's why we have a lot of its footage. So this is pretty rare footage of Sifu, so let's really enjoy the moment together. Thank you.
This means good luck, and it's for the chef here at the Mandarin Restaurant. Hi, I'm Jan Yanahiro, and this is Steve Fox.
Jan, from what I can see going on behind us here, the chefs are going to need good luck to juggle all this.
Actually, I think they're doing pretty well without any much help, but it's for Chinese New Year's, and it is a tradition.
More on that in just a minute. As Jan said, we're going to see traditional Chinese meal being made and eaten and celebrated here at the Mandarin, but we have a lot of other things in the program as well this evening. Bob Hirschfeld will find the best Chinese silk in the Bay Area. Merle continues to celebrate Chinese New Year. Paul Nguyen will have a movie tip. And later on in the program, Jan will introduce us to a Tai Chi master, I understand.
That's right. He's terrific.
We'll see him work out early in the morning.
5 o'clock in the morning.
Looking forward to that. Now, we would like you to meet the lady who
owns this.
It is way before the time I get
out.
However, students are already gathering in Portsmouth Square right here, waiting for Master Kuo Lien Ying, the master of Tai Chi. They're all his students. They come out here every day at 5 o'clock and practice the art of Tai Chi for about 2 hours.
Thank you.
Master Kuo, could you explain what Tai Chi is all about? I understand that the movements come from animals. It dates back from the very, very old ages when there wasn't man, then animals used to fight with animals. After man came, man had to fight with animals. By fighting with animals, man learned the gestures and the movements. Therefore, man developed different movements and practice with man. What does it give you, and what does the master give you in this art?
Well, it's a daily practice that we come out, and I feel it's as vital to me in my life as eating or sleeping. It's become almost a necessity. If I don't do it, I don't feel right every day.
What about the master? What does he impart to you, or what does he give to you?
Well, just looking at him, he's 83 years old this year, and I don't think you'll find too many men at that age as active and as spunky as he is.
Do you think that the students revere him because of his age and his knowledge of the art?
Yes, yes. He's studied with the best in China, and just his spirit that he gives off to people, his energy he gives to people, and it inspires people to work hard at the art, and it's an inspiration. He says that if you practice Tai Chi, you can live to 150 years old. If anyone is going to live to 150, I think he'll be the one to do it.
Master believes one has to be modest. Being modest means when people criticize, when people get mad at you, do not react. Try to ask, why do people criticize? Why do people...
His secret is to practice Tai Chi Quan every day and eat whatever is good for you. He recommends garlic.
Garlic?
Right. Raw garlic.
Are there basic rules, Master Kuo, that you follow in your life and with Tai Chi that you can impart to the rest of us in your secret for good health and longevity?
他希望知道您是不是有几种基本的条例是您遵守的，可以教给普通的人，大家也能学一下，也能长寿，也能保身。要穿生意，要是穿生意呢，不要生气，要乐气，啊，好人正气，什么也是嘻嘻哈哈的。
The greatest secret is not to be angry. You have to preserve your inner strength, and you have to be very peaceful. Do not get angry. Once you get angry, you lose your inner strength.
Is inner strength then the secret for Tai Chi and becoming a master and doing it so well?
养气内功是不是就是做一个太极师父的一个最重要的
重要的重要的哎你看我的手你看这看我的手
Oh yes, so smooth.
还绵还绵绵的，二十多岁。
So soft, like a 20-year-old hand.
Right. So how does he keep his hands that way, so youthful and young and soft?
就说您的手是怎么样保养的那么好的？
就是练的，不是保养。
It's by practice.
外功嘛，外力怎么发出来？
From his inner strength. And sit in.
Excuse me, his mic is really hot. That's him. This is him. I turn this down a little bit and the rest of them.
Chan, tap on the mic, please.
Okay, that's okay. That's quite all right. Mm-hmm. Master Kuo, could you explain what Tai Chi is all about? I understand that the movements come from animals.
郭师傅，他希望您能解释一下那个太极拳的那个基本动作是什么，因为他听说那基本动作呢是跟了那个动物的那个动作而来的。
我们有八个基本动作嘛。
There are eight fundamental movements.
太人在古语学家就说是啊，古语学家是身为球龙，腰为球肘。第一要紧就是腰部。
最要紧是要什么？
腰部。
要补。
腰部。第二个是腰部。
The most important part is the waist.
What about the movements? I understand the movements are derived from animals. Mm-hmm. Can you explain what that is all about? How the history has come about for the martial arts and Tai Chi?
他想知道一下，是不是动作跟那个动物，兽类的动物有一点关系，是那么样发展出来的。
兽的东西我们今天没跟你练有心意，这个东西这个汉唐朝以前没有人的时候就是兽跟兽长，有的人啊就是人跟兽长，他就别出这么个东西来，有点磨练着就人跟人练。
It dates back from the very, very old ages when there wasn't man, then animals used to fight with animals. After man came, man had to fight with animals. By fighting with animals, man learned the gestures and the movements. Therefore, man developed different movements and practiced with man.
Is Tai Chi a defense? Is it a martial arts to defend oneself? Is it Tai Chi? Is it one's for longevity and peace? What exactly is the purpose of Tai Chi?
太极拳主要的一个那个意义是攻还是守？
又攻又守。
It is both defending and attacking.
And inner strength and peace, that too?
同时又是一种内功。
你说这个内功，都是他们大学的学生们，这个比大学好，比大学好无穷的，无穷的，
To practice inner strength, Master demonstrated this movement, which means the eternal strength, and it is much...more beneficial than the martial arts itself.
Why do you have to get up so early at 5 o'clock in the morning to practice Tai Chi?
您为什么那么早就起来了？早上五点。 The reason he gets up so early, it is dawn. Dawn is the beginning of daylight. And he actually gets up at 4 o'clock. He has his 1 hour practice inside before his students come at 4:45. So it is the beginning of the day, which is between 4 and 5 o'clock.
What feeling do you have, Master Kuo, when you're out there doing Tai Chi and doing, going through the motions? What do you feel? What do you think about?
当您在外面在那个广场上打太极的时候, 您心理上感觉到是什么样的一种的感觉?
这个我们练功夫啊, 完全是个意, 你这个意是要干什么? 不是要用力，要是做一下，用一下行动的意，每一个姿势是用用的。不用的时候他就不练了。我们不能说打人，要打人的时候，出手就打死你，连第二下也不要用。When
one practices Tai Chi Chuan, it is very important that you have the inner strength, and what you have in mind, you have to not only control, but to cultivate your inner strength so you are at peace. Although you are very powerful, but it is not for you to use any of the power you have, because otherwise you can hurt a person easily by one stroke.
What, can I ask him again, what does he feel when he does, does he feel healthier when he does Tai Chi? I wonder if Master Kuo, do you feel strength or healthy, an exuberation of health when you're out there doing your motions, your Tai Chi motions?
他很想知道您在打太极的时候，是不是心理上感觉到身体也觉得是非常的健康，气也运了，是不是对一切都非常平安，是不是有这么一种的感觉？
不能有你这种感觉，我们一打拳是注意每一个姿势，什么回事？每一个姿势怎么回事？打开打在练到尽头，没有跑姿势。He
abandons himself completely in the movement, in every single movement. He gives himself completely. Therefore, there is no other feelings nor thoughts. He is completely involved and penetrated into his movement and blending into one.
That's very nice. We saw your son, Cheng Meng, doing a lot of different movements and sets of Tai Chi, and he's very good. Do you want him to become a master like yourself?
他们看见令公郎宗美表演几套拳,
他们也想知道您是不是也希望宗美长大了，也是做一个太极拳专家呢？那个，我讲，这现在小了，动作就得练。他要恐怕要是大了，动作练了小点了，又追求小点了，恐怕就太缺要丢掉了。
A master has a very good attitude. He said, Zhongmei is still very young. That's why he is willing to practice. But when he grows older, he might have other interests. So he doesn't know whether Zhongmei could continue and persevere, although he does wish him to continue.
Do you feel, Master Kuo, that Tai Chi can benefit everybody?
您是不是觉得太极拳对所有的人练的时候全有益处？处处有益，
处处有益。 孩子你看我们那个小撇子那内功那是那武穷的功夫啊你看他大人熊的很大人熊的很这个东西啊我怎么跟你讲啊我从小就是太少我们总没大理也有教了我说是他要练个小姐我那第四个太太 八个小孩，也没功夫没有干。早上我去的请太太就到了别的旅馆住去了，还是四点钟叫我，大金子，你给我叫四点钟叫我，他把洗脸水转进来，我就马上我们就出北京天目外练去了。
Master begins to talk about his life when he was still in China. He said, yes, everybody benefits from practicing Tai Chi Chuan. He has gone through a lot in life. When he was young, no matter who he was with, where he was, he always got up at 4 o'clock in the morning, no matter how difficult the situations were. He has maintained the same practice, the same hour, and he believes it is absolutely beneficial for men, women, children alike.
Does he practice any other healthy things? Does he ban all smoking and drinking? I mean, does he give into health foods? Does he also advocate those things to go along with Tai Chi?
他想知道是不是您也是不喜欢禁止吸烟、禁止饮酒，这些是不是也是对养生也有益处的？
您是不是也禁止人家禁止吸烟、禁止抽烟、禁止喝酒？酒要少抽，是要多治，烟也抽，酒也喝。是这个地下长出来的东西，是坏东西，他就不抓了。抽烟好啊，抽烟少抽，我也抽烟，一天四支。
Master has a philosophy, is everything has to be very natural. Anything that grows from earth cannot be bad. Therefore, if you want to smoke, do not exaggerate. If you want to drink, do not go too far. Anything that is not exaggerated is beneficial for your health.
I would like to, Master Kuo, has Tai Chi given you the peace and the inner strength that you have sought in your life?
他想知道您一辈子对太极拳那么多的成就，是不是给你一种内心的平安，跟对 of overexcitement, over anger, over sadness, and being over happy. All these exaggerated, it reduces 10 years out of each person's life. On plus of that, overeating, over drinking, over enjoying, 您说的最后一个是吃喝玩乐,
and
over relaxing, these four more overs also carried another 40 years, therefore reducing 80 years from a person's life. That's why the average age now is only 70.
Do you expect Master Kuo to live to 150 years old?
您希望能够活到150岁吗？
自己都说早见了，乐器给我中，啊，说话也中，说这始终保有乐器，就和我们他们见过我们过去点油灯，点一个油灯，没有了就贴上，没有了贴上，这不是就叔叔大了吗？要是挂好有好有好感了，贴不是油。
He said, life is something that you really have to cultivate the inner strength. Now he gives an example of inner strength like an oil lamp. The lamp burns, the oil burns up. And you add more oil, the lamp continues. The oil is something like the inner strength that you cultivate, and it comes, it renews itself. So as long as you continue this process of renewing your inner strength, this little flame of the oil lamp continues burning.
Thank you very much. It's very nice.